Heated scenes are expected at a public meeting in Wanganui tonight, where residents will voice their concerns over next month's release of sex offender Stewart Murray Wilson. One of those attending will be Te Tai Hauauru MP Tariana Turia, who's been told Wilson will soon be her neighbour, and she joins us now. Morena, Taria. Tariana, what exactly do you know about Stewart Murray Wilson?
Well, we know that there have been 33 offences. We know that he has never, ever admitted any of them. So what we've got really is a person who, despite very, very serious offending, will not acknowledge that it has taken place. And I think that therein really lies the significant issue for people in our community, because if somebody never admits they've done anything wrong, they are highly likely to reoffend.
Is that part of the reason why the meeting's being held this afternoon?
Well, I think the people are fearful, because when you don't get communicated with appropriately, when you're not consulted that somebody of this nature is coming into your community, regardless of all the protections that are around, people get very, very concerned, and many people are frightened. And for women who have been in that situation of being preyed upon, many of them are incredibly frightened. So it's raised a lot of angst in our community. And I think that, you know, look, I'm a person who believes in reintegrating people back into community. But when you look at the conditions around this man, there is no reintegration. He will simply live in a house out at the prison. He will be denied all contact with everybody. And some people will say, good. But is it good? In the long run, you know, what can we expect from this person if they have very little or minimal contact with anybody? I don't think it's healthy for him, and it's certainly not healthy for our community at large.
You say that the community wasn't consulted. Police and corrections say that they've been trying to involve lots of people. Had they have consulted, I'm not sure that many communities would have wanted him to be in their neighbourhood.
Well, you know, when they say that they had consulted, I was only informed last Wednesday, and I live in the road where he will be paroled to. So if that's what we call communication and consultation, I don't think that's good enough, because in the end, all people were being told is he is coming to Wanganui. They weren't asked how they felt about that, what the conditions would be, how they would respond to this situation at all. And I think we've already had one meeting at the weekend. I won't be going to the meeting tonight, but I will be, you know, taking advice. People have been emailing me and telephoning me, very, very concerned about the long-term safety of the residents of Wanganui.
So you're encouraging everybody in Wanganui that is concerned to turn up to this meeting this afternoon, yeah?
Well, I think they should, or they should take the opportunity to email the minister. You know, I don't really know what we can do to stop him coming into our community. We've been told very clearly that he has to go somewhere. Because there are so many victims, there are very few places around the country that have a facility in like Wanganui that can in fact take care of him. So, you know, on one hand, I have to say that he and the Wanganui community have been let down, because the protection legislation that was meant to have been put in place hasn't been put in place yet. There are six offenders of the same nature as this man. Something should have been done about it earlier.
Do you fear for your safety?
No, I don't. I don't fear for my safety. I think that what the department has done is put in place a whole lot of rules around him. In fact, when I looked at all of the rules, I couldn't help but think, why are you bothering to let him go? Because they are quite stringent rules. He's not allowed any contact virtually with community. So, no, I don't feel fearful for my own safety at all.
Thank you for joining us this morning, Tariana Turia, Te Tai Hauauru MP, and also concerned.
This update is brought to you by ANZ, proud sponsor of the New Zealand Olympic team.
Prison officials and police are right now fronting up to more than 250 Wanganui residents concerned at plans to release the serial sex offender known as the Beast of Blenheim into their community. Stewart Murray Wilson will live in a house outside the security fence of Wanganui Prison. Sarah Batley is at the meeting and joins us now live from there. Sarah.
The meeting's being held in the room behind me. It's absolutely packed. There's standing room only. People are spilling out into the foyer here. This is the first time authorities have fronted up to a public meeting about Wilson's release. But after talking to residents as they arrived at the meeting, it seems they're going to take some convincing.
We don't want that beast here in Wanganui. He can go and live next to the Justice Minister.
They say that Wanganui is the only place for this guy. They obviously didn't check out other places like One Stewart Island, Seal Island, White Island, or even the outbacks of Australia.
Sarah, obviously community feeling is running very high. So what does Wilson's lawyer have to say about its reaction?
Well, Wilson's lawyer, Andrew McKenzie, says while there are understandable concerns about someone like Wilson moving into their backyard, some of those issues are exaggerated, and he does think his client's safety will be an issue for authorities.
There's been no specific threats to my understanding at all, but obviously there's a lot of talk about people coming to meet him and protesting and the like, and I see been quite a lot of wasted police resources protecting Wilson in an area where he just simply doesn't want to be.
Now, Mr. McKenzie has filed an application to the High Court for it to consider whether the conditions under which Wilson's being released under are lawful. That will be heard next week. And the Wanganui District Council's also seeking legal advice to see whether there's anything they can do to stop Wilson coming here. They're holding an extra council meeting tomorrow night to discuss it.
Sarah Batley in Wanganui tonight.
This One News update is brought to you by ANZ, proud sponsor of the New Zealand Olympic team. Close Up is brought to you by the Kia Sorento R, redefining the power of Kia.
Now, things are getting tense at a public meeting in Wanganui. The meeting's happening right now. The residents there are not happy about their prospective new neighbour, notorious sex offender Stewart Murray Wilson. Now, as we said, at the meeting, Jahan Castanada says it's getting heated. People are shouting, answer the question, at senior police officers who were there with corrections to brief the public. Former Mayor, current councillor Michael Laws is going to speak to us very shortly. But first, Jahan gauges the city's mood.
Murray Wilson said he wanted to go on a caravan trip after his release from prison. No way, said the corrections department. We'll send you to Wanganui instead. And this is the welcome Wilson is getting.
You have no way of stopping a predator, I know. I was a victim from the age of 7 to 10.
Locals tonight showing their frustration about their new neighbour.
I'm 41 years of age and I still sleep with a freaking light on. You allow a monster to come in here, you have no idea what he's about to do.
In 2 weeks, Wilson arrives in Kaitoki.
It's a good place, a good pace of life, and a nice area. A lot of nice people, families, average, middle of the road, working class families.
But those families aren't rolling out the welcome mat.
Nobody is going to put their hand up and volunteer to have him.
This is where Wilson's new home will go. An old state house is being brought in. And there's the welcome sign from his landlord. He won't get to know his immediate neighbours. They're all behind bars at the prison.
He's chosen not to be rehabilitated, and when I asked the probation what his attitude was like, they said he was resistant.
These families have lived here for generations, but they were given just 3 weeks' warning that Wilson is moving in.
That this was basically a courtesy call.
Just a courtesy call?
Just a courtesy call.
Yes. No consultation in advance?
No consultation at all.
Wilson will be under strict conditions. He'll have no cell phone coverage and he'll be monitored by GPS. But locals say he'll still be too close to women and children.
We are actually in very close proximity to the city, and it's a hive of activity through the summer with the use of the lake.
One of his neighbours is even an MP, but she's powerless too.
And of course I think there should be huge concerns about his personal safety as well, given the feelings in the community.
In the past hour, officials have tried to allay locals' fears.
Get the opportunity to ask the questions you will have.
But the resounding message is simple. We know he has to be released, but not in our backyard.
Now, the former mayor, current councillor Michael Laws, has been in that meeting, which we have heard has been getting very tense. Look, thanks for joining us, Michael Laws. Tell me, what is going on in there? I can hear it behind you.
Yeah, I mean, there is a growing sense of frustration and an enormous upset from the Wanganui community that essentially we're ending up as a dumping ground for one of New Zealand's worst sexual offenders without any consultation whatsoever. Corrections really intended this and the police, I guess, to try and explain things and SOH fears. I've got to be honest with you, it's gone absolutely nowhere and the anger has got more palpable as the meetings moved on.
Have they said anything, Michael?
I think there have been some interesting things that have come out of it. The head of corrections himself, the chap that's here at the moment, nice guy, but doing an impossible job, he said, he finally, the meeting broke him down and he said, no, I don't want this guy next to me. Boy, I'd be feeling exactly the same way as you if it was in my backyard. And the reality is that the other thing that's coming out of this is that the training of the minders is happening now. So it hasn't been weeks or months in preparation. It's happening as we talk. This guy's getting out on September the 1st, before that, in 2 weeks' time, and he's going to have a whole series of people who have been trained to look after him now. It's just ludicrous.
Look, the fact of it is, though, none of us, to be honest, would want him living near us. I wouldn't, you wouldn't. I think no one around the country is going to put their hand up and say, come to our town. So what do they do with
him? But you know what the answer to that question is from the government and from corrections and the police? It's, well, put him in Wanganui then. I actually think, in a funny sort of way, Wanganui is fighting a fight on behalf of all communities in New Zealand. And that is, it is not adequate, it is not an excuse, it is not in any way okay for you to dump really bad criminals who are going to offend again in any of our communities. And there has got to be a change to the law to make sure that these people don't get out. It's really as simple as that.
What about the argument that, say, there was a serious offender in Wanganui, if he were, or she was then released, they would be sent somewhere else away from their hometown because they can't go near their victims. So they've got to go somewhere. You guys are just on the wrong end of this one.
Yeah, interestingly, it's funny you should say that because there is a precedent for this chap, and it's Lloyd Alexander McIntosh, who corrections treated exactly the same way. The really worrying thing is the way in which corrections treated him. They first of all cut his care in half because it was costing too much to the budget. And let's make this clear. This man's going to cost about $350,000, $400,000 a year to look after on this basis at the moment. Then they actually allowed him to go and look for a job in a bar right across from a primary school. That was under direct correction supervision. You can imagine if that happened here. 12 of the 17 conditions that the probation service set, Mark, 12 of the 17 can be altered with the wave of a probation officer's pen. That's really worrying.
OK, look, the difficulty you have is that he's heading to Wanganui, that they're not offering you any alternative, they're saying is going to happen. If he does up in your city, what are you going to do about it?
Tomorrow at 6 o'clock at the council, there is an emergency council meeting that myself and other councillors have called to determine exactly what the Wanganui official response is. I've got a motion on the floor tomorrow that says that we do not accept the decision and that we will use every means, political, legal, administrative, to fight that decision. I don't think that we can afford to take this lying down as far as our community is concerned. And frankly, we need to stop new victims happening. This man is just a disaster waiting to happen. And I'll tell you what, he's not going to be a disaster in our backyard.
I don't envy your decisions there tomorrow. As you say, I think every community in the country is looking at what is going to happen there in Wanganui. Michael Laws, a councillor, thank you for joining us tonight.